If Cartoon Network is known for one thing, it's cartoons. Shows like Dexter's Laboratory, Ed, Edd n Eddy, Courage the Cowardly Dog, and many other classic cartoons. But does anyone else remember the time Cartoon Network got real? It was the mid-2000s, and Cartoon Network executives were all sitting around wondering how to make more money. They looked to their contemporaries, Nickelodeon and Disney Channel, for ideas. They saw how much money they were raking in with shows like iCarly, Drake and Josh, Zack and Cody, Hannah Montana, and many others, and thought, what if we did that? And then someone in the boardroom said,
but sir, our name is Cartoon Network, shouldn't we make, cartoons?
Then he said,
who cares what you think? Think about all the money we could make.
And that's how Seeing Real was formed.
You're watching Cartoon Network. I'm Andrew WK. This is a visual aid. This is our Cartoon Network programming visual aid. The white represents the cartoons we show most every night. And this represents CN Real on Wednesday nights. Ring Rush, Destroy, Build, Destroy, The Othersiders, Survive This. It all starts at 8. Wednesday nights, CN Real, only on Cartoon Network.
The CN Real block premiered on June 17th, 2009, with the shows The Othersiders and Survive This, followed by Brain Rush and Destroy, Build, Destroy on June 20th. And finally, we saw the last two shows to air on the original block, Bobb’e Says and Dude, What Would Happen, which premiered on August 19th. These shows were all met with negative reactions, but did they really deserve it? Well, we're gonna find out. Today I'm going to watch one or more episodes from each series to see if I can catch the gist of why CN Real failed, starting with The Othersiders was Cartoon Network's take on a ghost hunting reality show. If you've never seen shows like Ghost Hunters or Ghost Adventures, the premise is basically that a team full of people go to reportedly haunted locations to prove if ghosts are real. This show stars a team of five friends: Riley, the lead investigator; Zach, the tech manager; Jackie, the researcher; KC, the case manager; and Sam, the webmaster. The show lasted for a total of 23 episodes, amounting to 2 seasons. And this show is awful. As a kid, this was the show that made me realize ghosts weren't real. Everything in this show is so forced and fake and overly dramatic, which is crazy because that literally describes every ghost show. But this one takes it to the next level.
52 recorded passenger deaths here on the ship. Not to mention hundreds of deaths of the soldiers as well. So quite a few real hot spots on the ship, if you know what I'm talking about. One of them's the pool.
The pool?
They've got a vortex area there. Also, there's a little girl who's known to visit the pool. There's the engine room. Of course, we've got a couple of boiler rooms. There's activity all over the ship. So, good luck.
Thanks.
See you later.
See ya.
The acting is so phony, and the evidence, in quotations, is basically non-existent. Every episode, they'll see a shadow or hear a bang or something, and they'll say, all right, let's pack up. They'll hear about a myth that happens at the place, and then the exact same thing will happen to them. Then they go back to their base and discuss their evidence.
So when Riley and I were in the boiler room, we did some call and response, and I listened back to the voice recorder we used. This is what I found.
If there's someone here with us, please show us a sign. Or do something previous that you've done before.
Oh, no way! That's insane. Did it say get out?
Yeah.
It totally said get out. Yeah.
That's crazy.
Like a demonic get out.
That sounds like some...
That is evil.
Oh my.
Did you really hear that creepy?
No, it's no. Definitely.
Well, we kept hearing like metal chains.
We heard a banging.
I heard it from the pool room.
We heard banging.
Oh my god, there's a bang at the door!
Or like something falling. We've
been
metal dropping.
But then we would check and there'd be nothing there.
Yeah.
That's what I did.
That's creepy.
Oh, that was like, that. That was like demonic.
That is crazy.
Definite EVP.
Oh. He was tired of us and wanted us out.
It almost never holds up and can be easily debunked. I also find it kind of gross that these kids will be talking about someone being brutally murdered in this building and they'll be like,
yeah, that's awesome. Maybe we can get some sick evidence out of this.
Like, I know they're just kids, but it still rubs me the wrong way. It always sounds like they're reading from a script, and whenever something happens to them, they immediately assume it was a ghost without taking any other options in mind. I watched 3 episodes, which I think was more than enough. The same exact thing happens in every episode. They find a place to go to, see a shadow or hear bang, pack up and go back to base, then say, yeah, this place is haunted, and the episode ends. There's absolutely no reason to watch this show. It adds nothing to the ghost hunting reality genre except making the team a bunch of teens, but that just makes it worse since the acting is so terrible. So yeah, this show sucks and definitely started seeing real on the wrong foot. So let's see if the next show is any better. Survive This is one of those reality shows where a bunch of people have to go into the woods and survive. It's in the same vein as like Survivor and Alone, except this time it's with teenagers. The show's host is Les Stroud, don't know if I'm saying that right, and I've never heard of this guy before doing research for this video. He did a show called Survivor Man, which I've never seen before, but it lasted for a pretty long time, so it must have been at least somewhat successful. I've always been more of a Bear Grylls guy myself. Before I talk about the show though, I gotta complain. I didn't watch one episode. Not because I didn't want to, but more so because I didn't want to pay to watch it. From the trailers and clips I watched on YouTube, it just looks like a generic surviving reality TV show, but with kids. If you want to knock on me for not watching it, then I want you to watch it and tell me if I'm right with the predictions I make. So, let's go. You got Les Stroud, who kidnaps these kids, who usually fall under the stereotypes of jock boy, nerd girl, popular girl. And he takes them to the woods or something and makes them sleep outside and eat bugs, and then drama starts to emerge amongst our epic cast of characters. I've seen enough survival shows to know what's going on. I mean, they're almost always the same shit.
This is about survival.
They come from different backgrounds.
I think I'm definitely a city boy.
I would say I'm a country girl at heart.
I have been called a princess.
To succeed, they must work together as a team.
She doesn't really know what she's doing. Well, actually, none of them do.
We don't really have a plan right now.
Here's my idea. How about someone come over and help me?
The survival situations I throw at them will get tougher and tougher.
Look out!
Green?
Oh, this is terrible.
Each participant is responsible for his or her own fate, and it's up to the individual to choose when it's time to leave. I'll check in on their progress at predetermined points along the way, and I'll ask,
who wants out?
I don't know if I want to be here anymore.
Whoever can survive to the end will face the ultimate challenge. A solo mission, where I'll expect them to endure, document, and conquer surviving alone, just like I do.
So right now, seeing real is 0 for 2. The only thing they've done so far is taking existing reality show concepts and just putting teenagers in it. Maybe that would appeal to kids, but I feel like parents wouldn't want to watch it when they could just watch Ghost Hunters or Survivor. I mean, it's not like those shows are super vulgar or that inappropriate for kids.
Look! What is that? What is that? I'm pretty sure that's their television! Oh man, I am really scared! Whoa! What is this? What is this? There's a wetness coming from my pants! I see it! What is it?
I loved watching Ghost Hunters and Ghost Adventures as a kid, but seeing kids do it is just so lame. I like man children who use the Xbox Kinect to find demons in people's houses. So after all that, let's see if the next show on the CN Real block, Brain Rush, is something different or just a cheap imitation of another reality show.
What do 100-foot drops and mind-bending twists and turns have to do with winning? Big cash, everything. You've just stepped into the game show where you can win some serious money if you can answer some simple questions. And what's the catch? I knew you would ask that. You gotta do it while you're riding this. The best part is you don't know you're actually on a game show until you sit in the seat. Surprise! You're on Brain Rush.
I had no idea what to expect when going into Brain Rush. I just knew it had something to do with roller coasters. The concept of the show is that the hosts, Lamorne Morris and Sarah Cargis, something like that, find three contestants at an amusement park and then make them answer trivia questions while they're on the ride. They earn money for getting questions right, and that's about it. The show only lasted for 6 episodes, which doesn't surprise me too much because there's not really much you can do with this concept. The show reminded me a little bit of Hot Ones, although in Hot Ones it's an interview and not a trivia game show, but it's kind of the same idea of putting someone in an intense situation and asking them questions. I don't know if anyone else noticed the similarities or if I'm just talking out my ass, but either way I had a pretty fun time watching Brain Rush. It wasn't anything amazing, and after 2 episodes, I think I got my fix of it, but the show is definitely carried by Lamorne Morris. This dude was just so funny and always saying out-of-pocket shit to these kids and making them act all awkward. There's just something so funny about him, and he was a very charismatic host, and I'm glad the dude is still working to this day, so props to him.
How's that sound?
Sounds good.
Sounds good, it sounds great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is awkward, Antoine, because you're still here. Yeah, I'll take that. Bye.
All right, man.
All right. Thanks for playing Brain Rush.
Is Brain Rush peak reality TV? I wouldn't say so, but I had a decent enough time watching it, which is more than I can say for the other shows so far. It's just simple, easy to digest TV where you answer the questions along with the contestants to see if you could have done better than them. I could see kids coming home after school in 2009 and yelling at the kid in the TV for only knowing 3 Transformers when they know every single one to ever exist and could have made $1,000 off one question. It was me. I was that kid. And I wasn't a kid. That happened 3 days ago.
Hi, I'm Andrew WK, and this is Destroy, Build, Destroy! Yeah. Yeah. The show where 2 teams compete to destroy stuff and then use the wreckage to build the coolest, strongest, most efficient machines they can. All right, guys, ready?
Yeah!
Let's do this! As always on this twisted show, we do things a little differently. I'm impressed. Well done. All right, guys, if you think that was cool, wait till you see what we got up next.
See the premiere of Destroy, Build, Destroy, Saturday, June 20th at 8:30. Part of the brand new See & Reel on Cartoon Network.
So now we're on to Destroy, Build, Destroy, which is basically the show that made me want to make this video. This was really the only See & Reel show I watched consistently as a kid, and I absolutely loved it. So let's see if Destroy, Build, Destroy lives up to the hype that 10-year-old me gave it. Destroy, Build, Destroy, or DBD, don't get confused with Dead by Daylight, is a reality game show hosted by Andrew WK, where 2 teams, usually falling into a certain theme, go up against each other to build a machine that's supposed to be used for a certain challenge. Like one of the episodes, they had to make a cart with like a Gatling gun on top that could shoot tennis balls at targets to get the most points, and another where they had to make a giant claw trap machine to pick up basketballs. At the start of every episode, Andrew WK usually blows something up like a car or a boat, and then the kids have to gather material to build whatever wacky contraption Mr. WK wants them to. Then around the middle of the episode, they take a break to play a wacky little challenge. Sometimes it's breaking down walls with a bowling ball, and other times it's chucking bricks at like plastic boats to sink them. Whatever team wins this challenge gets to set back the losing team, so they can basically fuck them over by dumping like a half ton of gravel on their vehicle and getting a nice time advantage. Then they go head to head to see who had the better vehicle thingy. Then whoever wins gets to decide how they want to destroy the losing team's invention. This show is nothing perfect, but it's definitely entertaining. Andrew WK is just running around and yelling like a schizo half the time, and watching people build these weird ass machines from nothing is pretty entertaining. And of course, watching a bunch of shit go boom appeals to my inner Michael Bay fan. This is probably the only show in this video that I could actually recommend, at least so far. Not because it's amazing or anything, mainly just because it's fun to watch with some friends and laugh at how cringe it can be and root for your favorite team. So I'd say if you're looking for something to do for a few hours, just go watch some DBD on YouTube. There's plenty of episodes there.
No, you zittin'. No, you zittin'. Oh, no, homeboy.
What's up? I'm Bobby J.
Bobby says, watch out.
Guess a little bit like regret. Bobby says, see? This is Bobby says.
Starting next Wednesday at 8 on CN Real.
Trying to watch Bobby Says is a lot harder than it should be, because the series is now considered lost media. You used to be able to purchase the series on iTunes, but that was long ago, and that shit's gone. The first episode was found in 2017, but now I can't find it anywhere. The only thing I can find now are short little clips of Bobby talking to Tony Hawk.
Thanks, buddy.
So, we're back at Tony Hawk's private complex. So, Tony, how long you been skating?
Like 30 years.
30 years?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So, I got one for you. You ever mess up?
All the time.
I know.
You do?
Yeah, wanna know how I know?
Yes.
We got your own video. Yeah. So, we gonna throw to this clip, and it's a little something I like to call Bobby Says, learn from Tony Hawk's mistakes.
The show starred Bobby J. Thompson, who was popping off at the time after his big role in the film Role Models.
What up, Ronnie? Good to meet you. What's going on there? Oh, Beyonce, she's smoking.
I don't want to take my pants off.
What? Whoa.
All right, Ronnie, that's enough. Language, Ronnie.
My language is English. And this mother grab on my hang down.
I got my own hang down to touch, kid.
Hokey has one of the handful on my ball.
Hokey, that's racist.
Well, I trust you two will work this out. I'm not gonna micromanage. Not my modus operandi.
I used to love that movie as a kid, and Bobby was fucking hilarious in it, so I need to watch it again and see if it holds up. But back on track, the show was about Bobby being in the streets of California and giving people life advice or something. I really don't know what this show is, but it just intrigues me. It only lasted for 6 episodes, so it's the shortest running live action series along with Brain Rush. I can't really tell you if it's good or not. I would love to watch it, but I just can't. Hopefully this show can get uncovered one day and I can finally learn if it deserved to be canceled or not. Bobby still does some acting here and there, so at least his career isn't dead. And last I saw, he was making some music. It's nothing super special, but it's not terrible either. He was grinding since a kid, and I can respect that, and I'm glad he didn't go the way of many other child stars. That brings us to the last show of the original CN Real block.
Wednesday after a brand new Bobby Says.
How do you guys feel about water? Ready?
Yeah.
Set, go!
He tried to walk on water.
Sort of.
Then, what blows up better?
With a giant air explosion. Dynamite.
So wait, we're gonna blow some stuff up.
And then,
our acne experiments are sensational.
So we have a car filled with 500 gallons of salad dressing.
Dude, what would happen?
Wednesday at 8:30 on Cartoon Network.
Dude, what would happen is what would happen if you took Mythbusters and replaced the host with three stoner buddies who come up with the dumbest ideas to set something on fire or blow it up. Our hosts are Jackson, CJ, and Ollie, and they're all pretty entertaining to watch. They just have this chemistry together that feels like you're getting stoned with these three rich kids that have access to flamethrowers. It's definitely a little mind-numbing to watch if you watch a couple episodes in a row, but an episode or two honestly isn't that bad. The hosts act so over the top that it always managed to make me laugh a couple times an episode, especially Jackson. Like the episode where they want to see if they can stick to a giant piece of bread with peanut butter and jelly. They're on like this mounted piece of bread that's dangling over a pool of milk, and they're trying to see who can stick to the bread the longest.
So the lab dudes built this contraption that has three giant loaves of bread and there's peanut butter all over them. To find out just how sticky peanut butter is, we're gonna see if we can hang on it while it's completely vertical.
No, I'm not falling.
Oh no!
Each of us chose a second ingredient to make us even stickier. Ollie used bananas, Jackson's peanut butter, and I'm jelly.
Train starts tilting us up and I'm holding on to my banana rock wall.
Oh my god!
Now as we got vertical, all I could hear was Ollie screaming.
No! 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 Suddenly the bananas became slippery. No! No!
Ah. No! No!
I was like trying to hold on to nothing. You could actually see my scratch marks in the loaf of bread.
My banana wall!
Now it was between me and CJ. I can feel myself already slipping. I look out of the corner of my eye, and I can see Jackson just slipping just as much as I am.
Ah! Oh, boy! No! Ah! 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 Oh! 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 What? I put way too much peanut butter on, and the peanut butter and peanut butter just canceled each other out.
It was my jelly that slowed my descent down just a little bit that gave me the win.
Peanut butter is the perfect glue. That jelly is the best sticky partner.
Peanut butter's glue!
It's so ridiculous, couldn't help but laugh. There's all these lab assistants who are always standing around looking like they hate their lives, probably wondering why they spent 8 years in college mastering the science behind physics or whatever, to working on the set of Dude What Would Happen, and seeing if these goofball stoner kids could cook a doll made out of bacon in a fire tornado. This show just reminds me of something that would be on Spike TV. It's a bunch of dudes who want to do the stupidest shit no one ever asked, and there's always something kind of fun about that. Dude What Would Happen and Destroy Build Destroy were the longest running shows from the original CN Reel lineup, and it's easy to see why. These shows both had charismatic hosts with a concept that would appeal to almost any 10-year-old boy. Blowing shit up.
Dude! Spend this President's Day weekend with the dudes that make Cartoon Network the coolest place to hang. Hosted by who else? The Dudes. The Dudes Make It Happen weekend, starting Saturday, February 13th at 10, only on Cartoon Network. Dude!
So CN Reel flopped harder than anything they've ever done before. All the shows were critically panned by critics and audiences alike. The only people that liked the shows were kids who didn't even know how to log into their computer yet, let alone know what the fucking IMDb was. It's obviously easy to see why these shows failed. They're airing on a channel called Cartoon Network. And guess what? They are not cartoons. That alone is the main reason why CN Reel failed. I remember as a kid thinking that it was blasphemy and pretty much refused to watch any of it before watching DVD like a year later. Plus, most of the shows were terrible and didn't deliver. Othersiders was a terrible ghost hunting show that no one would ever choose to watch over better alternatives that did a much better job faking their evidence. And while I didn't get to watch Survive This, I'm pretty sure it was the same way. It's just a cheap knockoff of much better survival drama reality TV. So the first half of CN Reel were basically all the brand versions of better shows with kids instead of adults. Then we have the weird middle child that is Brain Rush. Brain Rush was entertaining for a couple episodes, but by the third I was already familiar with the concept and the novelty wore off. I literally can't say anything about Bobb’e Says, And DBD and Dude What Would Happen seems to be where Cartoon Network found their footing a little. They knew little boys love watching shit get blown up and they just went all in. Now, did CN Real deserve its failure? Yes, absolutely. These were live action shows being made for a channel that was literally called Cartoon Network. A channel that is known for having cartoons. While some of these shows were okay, they still didn't fit on Cartoon Network. And I honestly think they would have done better on something like Nickelodeon or Disney XD. Something that also strikes me as weird is that they only did reality shows. They saw the success from all their other contemporaries, but their bread and butter were teen sitcoms, and it's just strange they didn't try that once in this first CN Real lineup. But a positive that comes from CN Real is that its failure drove Cartoon Network into a renaissance with crazy and out there ideas for cartoons that define 2010s animation. Shows like Adventure Time, Regular Show, Gumball, Chowder, The Misadventures of Flapjack, and even Clone Wars was getting really good at that point. Without CN Real's failure, I don't think Cartoon Network would have taken the risk to air those shows, which are all now considered some of the best animated shows of the last decade. Not even just kids animation, but animation in general. You can thank CN Real for that. So all in all, CN Real was a necessary evil we needed to put the greedy Cartoon Network executives back into their place and to start putting effort into cartoons and finding passionate up-and-coming artists to bring their vision to life. So I'm thankful for CN Real. Not because of the shows it gave us, because of the shows it would give us following its colossal failure. And that's gotta mean something, right?
Next Monday night is gonna be big.
First, it's a new episode of Adventure Time.
Why is my stomach going nuts?
Followed by a brand new Flapjack.
He's going through his man changes.
Then it's the season premiere of Total Drama World Tour.
Oh my God, this is the greatest day of my life!
And the series finale of 16.
I'm never gonna forget you guys.
That's a huge night.
Why did you wait so long to tell me?
And it all starts next Monday night at 8 on Cartoon Network.
Thanks for watching this video, guys. I know it's been a long time, but I'm back into the groove with things, so I just want to thank you for giving me your time. I got more videos on the way. I'm streaming on Twitch if you want more of me at MaxiDadTTV, and that'll be all. Remember to like and subscribe, and as always, I'm your host, MaxiDad. Stay smooth.